All right, so back to talking about Asia, actually, Asia itself, in the economy, and how it has been. We look into trade, we look into the trade movement of Asia. It's been since 2,000 years or more, even, the trade route from China, from all of their, over there, from Japan, Cambodia, all of this, all the way across through the mountains into Europe, you know, for years and years and years. And the major trade was silk. It was a silk trade. It started with silk. Now, and that was all. It was the bolts of cloth. It was not the clothing. It was the bolts of cloth. So what has happened is there's that, it's like they have to, you know, after so many years, you know, that's just the way, you know, they're going to be the trade route for bolts of cloth. And certain things, I believe, we do have to accept. So there they are, carrying the bolts of cloth, or bringing us the bolts of cloth. But when it comes to the actual making of the clothing, things have become excessive. So excessive as to where they do bring in entire cargo ships filled with clothing, and they park them at the ports, and nobody wants them. T-shirts or whatever, they're just there, parked at the port, and they don't have a buyer, they don't have a want. I believe that went on in, yes, France, when I was there. They are just like, no, we're not buying those clothes any longer. So something has snapped. Something has snapped in them, that they're just in this continuance mode and continuance mode and continuance mode. When in reality, we need to actually scale them back to when it was just the bolts of cloth. Just the bolts of cloth. You know, when we were only dealing with that. One deal, you know, the linens. The fine bolts of cloth and the linens. And other things, they started, of course, with the vases and all of that, you know, the fine, you know, fine items that you would give a king or a queen, not junk, fine items. But instead, they're showing up at the harbors there with this nasty, nasty ship filled with ugly clothing. Yeah. Something has gone wrong, you know, in their brain process. Something has gone wrong. You know, it's like, well, you've been accepting it. So when you overaccept, you've basically trained China. You've trained these lesser paid countries to bring you items. You've trained them. So I don't know. I just think we should never have let them do any more. You know, there's a point. You know, what you do over there that is really great and superior is you are the silk cloth. You know, we already know this. So that is your great superiority. Nothing else. You know, why does it have to keep going on and on and on? It's almost like if you go back that far, you know, what do you really want? What do you really want? You know, a king would turn that away, a queen would turn that away. Most of these items are just garbage. They're just junk clutter that ends up in people's houses. And I believe when you have the junk clutter arrival, you know, on these large ships, when you have the junk clutter, it's almost like it's almost like a bad joke, you know. It's a bad joke to the people, because it's just like, well, you guys will just completely ruin your houses, ruin everything, because it does. It just appears, it starts to become eclectic, ugly, because there it was for $3, there it was for $7. So you're living in eclectic, ugly. So in a way, they're bringing you, you know, you're supposed to have that beautiful, that chi, your house chi or whatever, your feng shui, you're not going to have it. Are you? So it's almost like they're bringing us ugly. They're bringing us an ugly ornament. So yeah, I don't know. It's really where I'm at right now with it. I'm really discussing this one issue. I think they just got carried away. Everything has just gotten out of hand. And we're like, okay, fine, their technology, and everybody sends their eagle cards there, whatever to be done. But, you know, that doesn't have to happen either. But maybe that's one good thing they do, you know. But does it have to keep going and keep going and keep going being everything? You know, stop it with everything. So, yeah, I don't know. When the imports are that, you know, they're just ugly. Where is that person to just say, no, I don't want that even anywhere near this land. Where is that person? That's just, why are they bringing in this terrible plastic junk? Why does a child have to go through his life and have 50, 100 plastic pieces of junk? Who made that rule? Why not have that child with only three beautiful toys? Three beautiful toys, handcrafted, made of wood. What happened? What happened to that? Why are we in this 100 gross build of plastic that's been generated by Mexico or China? You know, spoiled little brat children that fill their houses with more and more and more. You know, it all goes to the statement of who is running this land? Who is running? The people are not even capable. The people in general are not capable of making decisions other than it's Christmas, buy more. It's Christmas, it's a birthday, buy more. Buy it new, buy more. That's the only decision they're capable of making. So when you have like, hey, it costs $35 for that toy for that little child. Maybe that child only gets that toy once a year, instead of three or four times broken up into little chumpy pieces of plastic that end up in a landfill, whereas the other one is kept for years and years and years as an antique even. So I'm not really sure what's going on. How has that been allowed to continue and bring in all this ugly clutter? So yeah, along with the appeal, you know, we have their, appraisers there to say that that's not valued at a good price to us, you know. It may be $3 stated on your little memo, but to us, that's worth $13. Do you understand? So we stop it with the junk, we stop it with the cheap. We start to bring value products, quality products, back to the people. All right, so that was all, I guess so. I guess I'm supporting a craft fair, you know. But in the same token, why not? Isn't your house supposed to be filled with beautiful items from artisans rather than just garbage junk? You know, that lasts 2 years maximum, or melts in the microwave too fast and ends up in the garbage. You know, what's going on? Just get it out of here. Just get all of that garbage out. Don't allow it. Don't allow it in. I mean, we should make lifespan rules also for products. If a product does not have a lifespan that goes past 3 or 5 years, it should not be allowed here as an imported product. And I mean last that way and look new. You know what I'm saying? So yeah, really, really, it's just become the garbage league of the world, and it's just so sad. It's so sad. Americans are just, they've turned into just garbage dumps. You walk into their houses and they're just garbage dumps all over the place. And I don't care how hard you try, to be minimalist. It is so easy to just, oh my gosh, I guess I need some Tupperware or whatever. I need this little bit of that. You know, and it just starts flowing in. You know, it's just way too easy. So, yeah. I mean, the fight, it's almost, that's become our fight, is trying to be minimalists in this sea of just gross importation. Gross things that are imported again and again. So anyhow, yeah, you know, when I was a child and I never got a slide, I didn't need a slippy slide, you know. I went to whatever, the park or whatever, maybe there was a slide there. I certainly did not need one at my house. Bunch of little spoiled children with their big wheels, etc., etc. A bunch of little spoiled children. Yeah, plastic junk, you know, that hurts people's ears. It's a disturbance. You know, I mean, even that, why couldn't they make that product? A real good one. Just like the old days, you know, used to have those old tricycles or whatever. What happened to those? It didn't make that horrible sound. You know what I'm saying? Anyway, that's all. Yeah, and whoever wants to talk about unemployment rates, you, to give that data out on a generalization, don't be an idiot. That's a state by state. Maybe you could do it, but we're talking city by city. We're talking area by area. So you cannot even call that. And there are so many people who do not even list themselves under the government at all. So don't even state that you know what's going on by a statistic. The amount of people who are not working is massive.